Okay, so we want to try part two of this. We did the last episode was basically just the first hour of this mission. We got our population up to 2,300, and we're starting to get our defenses built. And I actually did record this episode the other day, but I forgot to save the game, so I'm having to start it over again. All right, so let's go ahead and start building. Now I'm going to go ahead and start out by building another fort of... if I can click on the right button, I'm going to build another fort of javelins right there. And also I'm getting ready to start building my villa block over here. And I'll also be putting in another block of housing over here. Let's go ahead and fix that. And we'll go ahead and put these in here because I just want to make sure that I do have enough furniture going. All right, now also I need to go ahead and put in a pottery industry. I am going to put right along here. This is going to be the warehouse for my clay, which I'm going to have to import. And then we'll have another warehouse right across the street, which was for the pottery. I'm going to start out with 6 pottery workshops. I may have to build more later. Now we'll just go into the trade advisor and tell him to start importing clay. And since I've built 6 workshops, then I'm going to import 12 units of clay. Just make sure I have 2 units per workshop. Sure that before I build any other warehouses, I need to make sure to set these to not accepting everything except for the pottery. Otherwise, they're going to start filling up before I can set them. All right, there we go. I'll have 2 warehouses up here getting pottery. I will also have two warehouses for furniture and two warehouses for oil to service this area. Right now I need to get some gears built down here. I want to move this prefecture and engineering post across the street here, because I'm going to make a area here so I can just put a crossroad right there. Just like so. So, there we go, another invasion. Fire! Start getting the troops out here. Okay, there we go. Took a few losses, but we beat them. Ahead and get our fifth one built, or sixth one rather. That will complete all of our legions. So we'll be ready for Caesar's request, which will be coming in here in a month or two. Okay, now every time I play through this, I've found placing my schools to be really tricky, especially getting the brats to run down this street right here. There they go. Okay. Sometimes I have to put my schools on the end, sometimes I have to put one over here. Okay, no, that's fine. Now for the palace block, or excuse me, the villa block down here, it's just going to be a single 9x9. Okay, there's the request for troops. Let's go ahead and just all these guys in and send them. We're not going to get any attacks while they're gone, so sending all of them is not an issue. And this is the spot where our triumphal arch will go when after our troops return. Temple or theater. I have displeased the gods. All right, so let's come in here and drop down a couple of oracles. Put one right there. There, there. Well, I don't think this is really going to be much of a problem. Just three guys, they'll come down here and get slaughtered by my towers. So I'm not particularly worried about that. However, I don't want to let God's anger fester. There. 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 Oh, there's way too many temples to series. I thought I selected all, but I guess I did. Well. Those. Because we like series, but not really that much. All. Now, when I put down my warehouses for oil, I'm going to move these two guys over onto this side. well, yeah, I've got to build mine. So. Those guys set up correctly, instead of accepting they need getting. Oops. Beat that one. Alright, and of course we won the battle, so we will be able to build our triumphal arch now. There. Now, just to make it easier on these guys to get, because I'm going to put a granary up here that is also accepting wheat. There. And I am not going to put in markets until these, all four of these granaries are full. There. And I may have mentioned it before, but the reason why I'm not connecting these roads up here is because I want this block to be the only one that gets wine. Pottery. This would be the one for furniture. I'm also going to go ahead and put down the warehouse for oil. This one will just be accepting the oil, because I want to import it to here and then have it, the warehouses down by my main housing area, come and get the oil. I am going to import 15 oil. Well, if I stop turning the trade off, there we go. Now that's going to be expensive, but I am not short of money right now. So that will not be a problem. So they are about, well, about ready. They are ready to have their amphitheaters put in. Let's go ahead and build the gladiator school. Well, I didn't really leave room for it over here, so I'm going to put it there. I originally intended actually to put it up there, but I got the granary there now, so scratch that idea. But that's okay, because I can put the lion house here when we're ready for it. Alright, now we're ready to put our two markets down over here. There and right there. Go ahead and slap down another oracle up here just because I can. Now, oracles don't actually need road access, so I'm going to just plop it right there, and even though we get that message, it's no big deal. So we'll drop in our triumphal arch. Oh, I thought I counted that. Well, time to do a little rebuilding. Sari. Right there. And then Neptune. There. Alpha Arch right there. Now, I'm not spacing these guys out one, because I found that if I just surround them with statues, that usually takes care of the desirability effects. Looks like I took a few losses. Phew, hell, looks like I lost half my force. Guess they were just all clumped up into one big group there. Now the next invasion will be coming in from down here, and it's going to be a fairly large one. Also there. And so I can put the gatehouse in. Well, build that oracle right there then. The oracles don't need road access, but they do need to be, I guess, at least within one space of a road so they can get the effects from an engineer. trying to build this quickly because that invasion is coming very soon. This bit of wall out here isn't really 100% necessary, but I like building it anyhow just because I can afford it, because as I've mentioned several times already, I am swimming in money. There they are. All right, now we've got a little bit of time to prepare for the next invasion. The next one is going to be the big one. Move all these guys back in. Now these fortifications here are to want to help deal with the big invasion which is coming in right there. Also make this pretty deep. And that's more or less even. Thank you. And they are here. Move these guys over this way. Okay, well, this is going a little bit worse than expected. Clean up over here. Cavalry against elephants usually doesn't work out too well, but right now that is what I have. This ain't that went badly, but we did manage to defeat them. I probably should have made this 4 thick instead of just 3. Oh, let's build wheat farms. Oh, 4 wheat farms. Oh, and we have reached 1 hour. Okay. Go ahead and pause that. All right, so next time when we pick up, all we have to do now is get our remaining 3,000 population in and get our culture up to 40 and just repel a few more invasions, and we will be done with this level. All right, and thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and see you next time.